The big one, yes. So C, little c, the speed of light. Probably one of the most famous symbols used in the whole of physics. It certainly appears in the most famous equation there is in the whole of physics, E equals mc squared. The c in there is the speed of light. And it's so it really is one of the most fundamental constants in the whole of physics.
C, small c, means the speed of light. That's what, 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, so 300 million meters per second. So it's fast, but not infinitely fast.
So it really is, I mean, it's the ultimate constant in physics, in the sense that it really is the same whoever measures it. That's what lies at the heart of special relativity, this idea that the universe is a relative sort of place, is that one of the precepts of special relativity is that the laws of physics are the same, whatever reference frame you're in. So if you're stationary, if you're moving, you should see the same laws of physics.
Why is the speed of light C?
Why is it set to be C, or why is it called C? That I don't know. I don't know why it's, I really don't know why it's, we've, how that constant has been defined as being called C. I'd be interested to know if Mike knows.
maybe because it's thought to be a fundamental constant, C for constant, but I don't really know.
People are kind of used to the idea that speeds add. So that, for example, if you see an aircraft taking off from an aircraft carrier, if you want to know how fast the aircraft's actually going, you have to add how fast the aircraft is moving relative to the aircraft carrier to how fast the aircraft carrier was moving forward. So the total speed of the plane is the sum of the two. And people are very used to that kind of idea, and in fact it's the calculation you use every time you cross the road to calculate how fast a car's coming towards you and so on. You're measuring relative speeds of things. But the weird thing about light is because the speed of light is always the same, it doesn't add in that way. So if you're piling along in a train and you shine a flashlight from the train and you measure the speed that the light comes out of the flashlight at, it comes out at exactly the same speed as if you weren't in the train in the first place. So speeds don't add. The speed of light, whoever measures it, however you produce the light, always comes out to the same value, C. That's not quite true. That's the speed of light in a vacuum. There are ways to actually get light to slow down. So there are certain, if light travels through air, for example, it travels a little more slowly. It can never go faster than the speed it goes in the vacuum, but you can make it slow down. And people do some really sophisticated experiments in the laboratory to actually slow light down to a snail's pace by messing around with what's known as the refractive index of the material, messing around with the properties of the material it's propagating through. So you can make it slow down, you can never exceed the speed that it goes in the vacuum. So C is in that sense a sort of cosmic speed limit, it's the fastest speed there is.
Does it have much to do with your work and speciality? Is C very important to you?
Well, for my sort of evening and weekend thinking about physics, yes, because I like to read books about cosmology and think about things like that. Most of the experiments we do in this lab, we're looking at electrons moving in semiconductors, which are moving at speeds well below the speed of light, typically about 1/100th the speed of light.
How do we measure the speed of light?
These days, it's a quite a difficult thing to measure. For the longest time, the experiments were quite crude, and the constraint we had on the speed of light were quite limited. Some of the best measurements we have nowadays are actually by doing radar echoes off things. You can actually just bounce a radar beam off things, because it's called the speed of light, but of course all electromagnetic waves travel at the same speed. So if it's a radio wave, an X-ray, an optical light, it all travels at the same speed. So by bouncing radio waves off things, we can actually measure the speed pretty accurately. So a good thing to bounce it off is another planet, because they were kind of a long way away. So because speed, the light travels extremely fast, it's 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, that's 300 million meters every second light travels at. So obviously you can't just sit there with a stopwatch and try and measure the speed of light that way, because it just goes too fast. Unless you can find something that's a long way away. So bouncing light off the moon, off other planets, by using strong radar signals is a very good way of actually measuring how fast that light's going.
And do you know exactly what it is?
I can't tell you exactly, no, because it's defined to an awful lot of decimal places. And one of the nice things about astronomy is we very rarely need to know things very accurately. And so, as I say, for an astronomer's purposes, it's 300 million meters per second, but actually it's not exactly 300 million meters per second.
Yes, it's something like 2.999 something, 8 × 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, but I can't remember that exactly. But 3.00 is a very good... 3.00 × 10⁸ meters per second is a very good approximation.
Oh yeah, 3 × 10⁸ meters per second.
Yeah. I cheat. I have a pocket calculator that's got all these physical constants built into it, so I just press the little button mark C and I get it to come up on the display without having to know the value.